Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna share with you how I create a design like this one that I did for my llama prompt for Design with Detour, this one right here. This style, I like to call it, I don't know what the exact name is, but I like to call it vintage extended letters. Here are some examples of designs that do the same thing. I'm gonna show you how to do this, but here's the twist. I'm gonna do it all for free. So I'm not gonna do it exactly the way that I showed because I used Affinity Designer, which costs money, and I used ChatGPT, which costs $20 a month. So I'm gonna show you how to do this, something similar to this for free, using Canva free and using some AI tools that are free. So a lot of people have been asking, how do I do this? I don't have any of these graphic designs. So you can do this actually for free, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. First, we're gonna go into Canva. I'm gonna create the letters. Then I'm gonna show you some AI options that you can use for free. All right, so here we are on Canva. Yes, I have Canva Pro, but I'm gonna show you the Canva free version things. First thing you're gonna do is come in here, create a design, and we're gonna go to custom size, and you can type in your 4500 by 5400. That's absolutely free. Type it in here if you don't have it as recent. I have it recent, so I'm gonna click there. Here's your artboard, and we're gonna start typing some letters. So we're gonna go to text. You can hit T on here, Command T, or you can just hit add headline, that's fine. And I'm gonna do one letter at a time, and I'll show you why. But first, let's type out the whole thing just to get some size. So type out the word that you're gonna put in. In this case, I'm gonna do yamen, which is a mashup of llama and ramen. So llama, mamen, I guess that's how you say it. So you wanna first type in the full word that you're gonna use. Now you can use any word here. You saw some of the examples before. And then pick the font. The font that I'm gonna use is free, and it's called Anton right here. So we just change it to Anton. And the reason why you wanna type in the full word first and not just the letters is you wanna get the size right. So let's just put this right here, what a full word would look like, boom. And then what you're gonna do is you're just gonna only type one letter at a time. So we're gonna come back here and delete all of this and do that one letter. So we're gonna put that right here, and we're gonna hold down Option and drag. So drag it, L-L-A-M-E, I'm holding down Option and Shift, N, right? L-L-A-M-E, and N. I have my caps locked as well, just so it's all capital. That's very important. It's hard to do this without having all caps. And the reason you want all caps is mainly because of this down here. You want it kind of straight. The better ones are the ones that have the straight bottom, like L's, right? They look like they can extend, but you can use it for some of these too. So some of the other letters like I, S would be a good one because it's more flat. Even though it's not flat, it has the bottom, whereas there's no holes here. So these with the holes or gaps in between kind of don't work that well, but we're gonna make it work. So make it spaced out as much as you want. So if this A is too close, now you can grab it, right? And then pull it there like that. The next thing you're gonna do is draw a rectangle. So we're gonna go to Elements, get your shapes right here, click on that, and then we're gonna do a rectangle for each one like this, right? And I'm gonna just copy, holding down Option and copy like this, and we're gonna get it close, but we're not gonna do it right exact. We're gonna zoom in to get it exactly right, but here's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna get it pretty close right here, like that. The next step that you wanna do is click on this, and you may not know this, but you're gonna wanna lock these down. So I'm gonna go to this lock right here and lock it down. So you can see now I can't actually click on it because it's locked down. So I'm gonna click on these. And the reason I'm gonna do that is because we're gonna zoom in here and we just wanna move these boxes and not the letters, right? So you can do one of two things. You can hold down Control and scroll in, or you can move in here, this right here, and just zoom in this way. Boom, boom, boom. And you're gonna wanna scroll up and zoom in right to where you can see these two, right? I'm gonna move myself here. And you can move side to side with this bar as well. See this bar down there? So we're gonna do that. I'm gonna highlight the box here and then just make it as close as possible. And we're just gonna give it just a little bit over. You can see I'm not going right at the bottom, and that's so that we don't have that line in between. And so I'm gonna move across and do the same thing with this one. Select that box. You can see I'm clicking and then dragging so that I can select the box, because sometimes it's kind of a thing that I wanna pick the letter, which I don't. So I'm gonna slide and say, yes, I want this box here. And so on. So I can slide this over, and you can see I'm just above this and doing that. Same thing, slide here above. So I'm gonna do this for all of them, and then we're gonna come back and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, so there, I finished all of them. Now I wanna select all of these and I wanna drag them down to the bottom. So just to give it that space, we're gonna make it go down there. And now that I have these, I'm gonna group the letters with the boxes, and I'll show you why. So I'm gonna zoom out just a little bit more so you can see it. All right, so we're gonna click on these again and unlock them there. And now I can click this and this together and group them. So I'm gonna hit Command G. You can see it's grouped. And the reason why I wanna group them is I can move them together. I can also color them. Now they're gonna be colored in a different way because one's a letter and one's a shape. But if I come in here and do the letter, and let's say I want to do like a red, bright red here, or maybe even this coral red, I can do that. And then I double click on the shape here and I can do the same coral red. And now it has the illusion that it's one long piece. Isn't that cool? So I'm going to do the same thing for these. I'm going to color this one. I know, pick another color here, maybe this peach. Right, and pick this box, and maybe this peach, again, same thing. So we're gonna go through this. I'm gonna color all of these. You can do them the same way. You can pick any of the colors. I'm just gonna do a rainbow of colors because usually that's what it is, but you can go find a color palette or whatever you want and pick, you know, in this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 colors. Depending on how long your word is, you might need more colors or less colors, and that's fine. So same thing, just come in here, pick the same color though. So come in here and pick the text color, which may be, let's say we want to do this yellow here, and we can pick the same yellow, right? So it's nice that it has the same color. And once you pick a color, it's going to come up here, so you can pick that same color. If you make a color for the custom color, you'll see it over here because it will be in your document once you make it for your text color. So let me do this right now, and then we'll come back after and I'll show you the results. All right, so there you go. Now you can see it's all in colors. Now the reason why we group these together, which I didn't group this one, but you wanna group it like that, is so that you can move it. So if you see that you want less space in between the letters, now that they're grouped, I'll group this one, you can kind of move them together. So you wanna keep this space at a minimum right here in between. Now this one may be too small, so I can come in here. I'll group this and I'll group this, I'll group this one. Now I can come in here, and because these are all grouped, I can just move it like that. So you kind of want the space in between these white spaces to be kind of even. That's what you're going for. And then you can select all of these and make sure that they're kind of centered. So now that we have the letters, we're gonna put a graphic right here. Now, you can use some free graphics on here. Canva has some free ones I'm gonna show you. Let's say we wanna look for a llama. Go here, graphics. Now, I'm gonna just look for free. And we could put any other graphics in here. This one would be kinda cool, right? Again, but this one isn't eating ramen, so the llama ramen mashup's not gonna work. But you can see this looks pretty cool. Let's see what else we got in here. We could do this guy right here, which is pretty cool. He's not eating ramen, but we could go and find some ramen. Let's see. And do that and just put in. The thing I don't like about doing this kind of mashup is these two things don't match, right? This is definitely a graphic style and this is a different graphic style, and they both don't match. So what I'm gonna do is try and do AI. So let me show you some free AI here. We're gonna go in design, elements. Oh, let's turn that off. And I think AI is down here. Audio, video, let's see. Yeah, you'll see right here, AI generator, create your own. So I'm gonna come in here. This is Canva's AI generator. It's free. If you're on the free plan, I think you get 50 for free. And I think if you're on the pro plan, you get so many a day before you run out. So let's just try it out. And I'm gonna do a llama. I have it all caps right now. A llama eating ramen, right? Maybe a cartoon llama. Let's just make it so, make sure it's a cartoon. Cartoon llama eating ramen. Now we get to pick the different styles here. Anime, film credit, photo, watercolor, whatever. We can see all, I think. Let's see if there's, well, there's a whole bunch of different ones. So I kind of like this concept art. Let's see if that works. And then aspect ratio square. Right, we wanted a square here, and we're gonna hit generate image. Now this may take a little while, so I'm gonna come back to show you what the results are. Now here are some results. I'm gonna put it up here. It is a llama eating ramen, but we want it knocked out. So what I'm gonna try and do is I'm gonna hit edit photo and see what happens when I remove background. Let's see if it keeps the llama and the ramen. Hopefully it does. And I think we can do some magic eraser too. Oh, this is cool. All right, so there we go. Let's do some magic eraser. And I'm gonna just erase this bowl. And I'm gonna, just thinking about it. Good, and I'm gonna erase this bowl here. Some of it I can't see, and it's gonna erase it. Great, and then we missed these things here. Great, so not exactly the same llama eating ramen thing that I had on my, that I did with ChatGPT, but this is free. This is free, and then I'm gonna go back to Magic Eraser, I guess. Boom. All right. So now we can make it like that. Totally free on Canva using their AI tools. And you can do this with anything else. Now, another AI tool that's free is Ideogram. So I'm going to show you what the results are there. But this is basically done right here. And we'll export it. But I just wanted to show you another free option that you could do with AI. But Canva's AI is pretty cool, pretty cool. But if you want a different look, let's go open up Ideogram. And let's see what it would do. I'll do the same prompt, a cartoon llama eating ramen. So here you go, these are the results from Ideogram. Again, you would have to remove the background on this one if you wanted to use this one. You'd also have to upscale it with DGB.LOL, which I've showed in some of my other videos. So there are some advantages and disadvantages of using AI outside of Canva if you're designing in Canva, because you might have to do some of those extra steps. But you can see it looks different. So if you're looking for a specific look, type of style and things like that, you may want to use things outside of that. Or you could just use the different prompts, the different styles right in here. So I use that one style, but you can see I could have used some of these other styles, minimalistic or any of these, to kind of dial in it. And you could also put that in the prompts as well. So there you go. Ramen, again, don't copy this exactly. You don't want to use this exact one because I'm already doing it, but you could use this technique for other prompts in Design with Detour, or other prompts that you're using for holidays or whatever. And then, you know, real easy to put this. The reason why this works is because it's filling the space, and then you're filling the lines on here with another design. Now this could be a little wider, and that would be cool. And you could put some words underneath like you've seen some other ones. So the way you would do that is just make sure that the lines don't go all the way down, leave some space for some words. I could have put right here llama eating ramen right underneath here in a different font. There you go. The next thing you would do though is, if you haven't done this already, is you would download, and it's not a transparent background, so you would have to remove the background in something else for free. Let me show you how to do that. PNG, right? 45 by 4500. This is not a free tool with transparent background, so I'm not gonna click it on. I'm gonna hit download, and we're gonna open up Photopea. Right here, and then I'm gonna take my downloaded PNG and I'm gonna just drag it into Photopea here. Sure, agree. Turn this giant thing off. And then we're gonna just select everything that's white. I can hold down shift and select this in here too. Right, like that. Great. And then I just hit delete. And now you have it knocked out. And now it's ready for print on demand. So I would come in here, file, export as PNG. Boom, it's already 4500 by 4500. You can see 4500 by 4500. Save it. Now this is gonna be saved as a PNG. Now this is the one you wanna use for print on demand. I'm gonna open it up here for you. You can see the gray means that it's knocked out. All right, so you don't wanna save, you don't wanna use that other one. Here's the other one. This is the one straight from Canva with the white background. You want the knocked out background, just like that. So there you go. That's the vintage extended letters technique. At least that's what I call it. And you can use it for a lot of different things. You can use it for a lot of different prompts. In fact, use it for some different prompts. Try not to do the same Bama design that I just did here. I know it's an example, but you can do something totally different and try it out with different things. Now, if you want to see another one that I did a long time ago, I'll put that video right here. This is one I did with Affinity Designer, same technique, but I added a little more things to it. So you might want to check that out so you can see how you can improve on it. The one I just did in this video is pretty simple. Of course, you can add and elaborate on it. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.